What I'd like to do now is to just add a bit more detail here to the ship in the middle of this editorial illustration. Now, as you can see here, it is in fact a linked file. So what I'm going to do is hold down the Alt or Option key and then just double click on it, which will take me out to the main file. So let's center the view up on that and zoom in just the shade so we can see it a bit better. And what I'm going to do is go to the layers panel and show you what we've got here. Okay, so we've got basically this base which forms the background and has a large key line. Then we've got all of these different main sections on here. Then we've got this mirrored layer. And if I just make that active, you can actually see there's a mirror me line across here. So anything I draw in the top half, because the arrows are pointing upwards, will be mirrored down onto the bottom. Now, I've created a new empty layer here called Add Hatches, and I'm going to add another Mirror Me axis to this so you can see how that's done just in case you haven't done it before. Now, I'll choose the Mirror Me tool, which is this butterfly, like so, and it should also open the panel. And as you can see here, I've got all of my Astute Graphics panels arranged in different parts of the interface. It's very, very handy. All apart from one, which I'm going to call for in just a second. First of all, I'm going to use this to add this axis and make sure that it applies to the layer. So anything I draw on the layer will be reflected across. And the arrows here are, as on the previous layer, pointing upwards. So the other panel that I was going to call for is the Astute Buddy panel. And I'm going to get that where all Astute panels live, here in the window menu. And you'll see Astute Buddy just here and the Astute Buddy panel. And this is a really handy panel. It will tell you a bit about any Astute tool that you have selected. And when you're working with the tool, it will also give you extra hints to keys that you can use to work with it. So much easier than trying to memorize a load of different shortcuts from a crib sheet or something like that. So what I'm going to do is just bring this down and I'll dock it with my interface just for now. Okay, so now that I'm ready with that, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to get to my selection tool. I don't need the Mirror Me panel just for the moment. And I'm going to unlock another layer. So I'm going to unlock this main sections layer and I'm going to select maybe one of these paths. Let's just do this larger path here. And I'm going to copy that. Relock this layer and then go to my Add Hatches layer and paste that in front. Command F, Control F on Windows. Now, so it's easier for you to see what I've actually done here, I'm going to change the color of this particular stroke. So you can be under no illusion that that is the stroke that's been pasted. And while that's selected, I'm going to use the Astute Offset Path panel. So Astute is another service from Astute, and you can find out more about that at astute.tech. So let's use it now to offset this path. What I'm going to do is I'm going to set this to -4 just here because I want it to be offset to the inside. I'm going to get it to replace the original path, and I'd like it to do 2 steps. I can then click Offset Path, and it will generate the path for me that I need. And I think that's pretty much exactly what I'm after. So what I'm going to use these paths for is essentially a guide so that I can place some other content. I'll close the offset panel, and I'm going to then draw a rectangle. So if I go to dynamic shapes here, and if I select my square, and I'll draw a shape. Now I'm going to hold down the shift key here to align it. And I'm going to change the size of that down to 4 millimeters here, like so. Done. Now I've done that, I'm going to style it similarly to the other strokes on the layout here. So I'll change the color here to a very dark gray, like so. And then I'm going to get my Orient Transform tool. Now you'll see that the Astute Buddy kicks in and tells me a bit more about that tool. Let's just close dynamic shapes for a moment. So down in the right hand side here, it's showing me that. And what I'm going to do then is click and drag between the two points at the bottom of the shape. If I now come down to this path, what I can do is click and drag here. I'm going to hold down the Alt or Option key to create a copy. And as I do that, if I just pause for a moment with those keys held down, you can see the key commands appearing inside of the Astute Buddy panel, which is really, really useful. Okay, I'll do with that duplicate. I'm going to move on a bit further and add another duplicate just here like so. And then I'll move around, add another one, and just over here, maybe one more. And then just perhaps another one close to that. And you can see how they are simultaneously being mirrored across onto the other side of the ship. I think we'll finish that off with just one more here, like so. Perfect. That's exactly what I need. I'm going to move to my selection tool now and get rid of the two green lines that I added there as a guide. And I'm going to add another set of hatches. But I'm going to do this a slightly different way. And I'm going to make them slightly smaller as well. So this one, I'm going to change down to 2 millimeters in both dimensions there, like so. And I think I'll also reduce the stroke weight so that it's just a bit fainter than the other hatches. There we go. Perfect. I think that will work really, really well. So once again, I need to offset a path. So I'm just going to collect one of these paths. I think this one here would be ideal. I'll copy that, lock that layer, go back to my add hatches layer and paste that in place. Command F, Control F. And again, just to make it easy for you to see, I'll change the stroke color like so. Next, I'm going to get the perpendicular path tool and I'm going to add some perpendicular lines. Now, as I mouse down and drag, you can see that the Astute Buddy is helping me out with the different shortcuts I need to work with this tool. So I'm going to tap A, like so, and then A one more time, and you can see that it spreads out along the path. I'd also like to randomize the height of these, so I'm going to tap R to do that, and you can see also that I can shuffle the randomness by tapping S. Now, something like that I think is going to work pretty well. I'm happy with that. And what this does by default is it creates a group of the new lines. I'm going to get my selection tool and double click on that group because there's a few that I want to remove. So I'm just going to remove this one from the end. It's not going to help me. And this one here. And I'll move through and just get rid of any of those that I don't think are really going to help. Okay, so I'll take that and maybe this one here. Let's get rid of that. And everything else is below the reflection line. So I don't need to worry too much about it. So just pull a few more of those away because I don't want a lot of hatches on there, just a few. And in fact, while I was drawing this, what I could have done if I'd wanted to was actually use the up and down arrow keys to change the number of lines. There we go. I think that's great. So I'll go back out to the main illustration and I no longer need the green line at the bottom there. And what I'm going to do is use Find Replace to actually place some hatches. So with this group selected, what I'm going to do is bring in the Find Replace art panel. And just as before, with all of the Astute panels, they're here inside of the window menu if you haven't built them into an arrangement like mine. Now I'm going to clear the current search attribute, but I'm going to look for paths. And I'm going to add an attribute, and that attribute is going to be stroke. Okay, and I'm going to try clicking the eyedropper and see what it picks up. So it's picking up color just here. So let me go and add that stroke attribute. And if I click this one again, I now know that I'm getting exactly the right thing. Just to check, I'll click on the magnifying lens here, and it's showing me what it's selecting. So I'll hold down Shift and click that again just to confirm that I've got that selection. So my search is exactly what I want it to be. Now I'll go ahead and select this hatch, and I'll hit the eyedropper in the replace field, which you access via the disclosure triangle. So I'm going to turn off this scaling option just here, but I am going to leave on the rotation option. I don't need to do anything else here, and I can deselect pick from group. But for positioning, what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose last anchor point. Now these lines were drawn from the base outwards, so this would be the first anchor point at the base, the last anchor point at the top. If I choose replace all, you can see that those lines have now been replaced, and I've got a whole bunch of hatches really, really quickly and placed kind of randomly. That enhances that no end. I can delete the original hatch art. Let's just zoom out and take a look at that. That's great. We can close that and save it. That's then updated in the main illustration, and we're done.